Oggi il denaro è creato dalle banche e prestato interesse alle persone. Cosa ne pensate di una riforma monetaria per eliminare il sistema basato sul debito delle banche centrali e della riserva frazionaria, che ci porta a una successione di crisi una dopo le altre, il cosiddetto business cycle? Secondo, è possibile per gli stati globalmente ripagare il debito con un'utopia e quali sono le conseguenze? Terza, perché gli stati sommersi dal debito, soprattutto adesso dopo la crisi, non possono emettere titolo del tesoro senza interesse a corso forzoso, come è stato peraltro già fatto da altri governi in altre epoche storiche? Grazie.
I think it's very important to emphasize, even with all of these crises, is that if you look around the world, you have plenty of examples of countries which have financial systems which are essentially underdeveloped. You have repressed financial systems, you have countries with banks, with very small banking systems, you have countries where credit is not available. And so I think we have our answer is, you know, crisis notwithstanding, an efficient, sophisticated, large financial sector is necessary to run a rich economy. That, you know, there's no real alternative. And really what we should be focusing on is regulation, supervision to minimize the risk. But the idea that you can somehow come up with, whether it's barter, exchange, some kind of localization system, it is, I think, you know, a solution which just carries out too many costs.
Professor Snow, giusto per specificare una delle domande che faceva lo studente, riusciranno gli stati a pagare il debito? È un punto molto delicato in questa fase in cui anche nazioni dell'euro come la Grecia sono nel mirino per i loro conti pubblici, quindi le giro la domanda magari con un'attenzione anche all'attualità di quello che sta succedendo ora.
Basically, this question whether the debt is repaid or not depends, obviously, on economic circumstances. A long boom, as you had in the Clinton years, that becomes something that looks more within your reach, and that is nothing. But more importantly than that, it is a matter of government decision making. If governments find it worthwhile, as they do and should, to invest in public goods like hospitals, roads, and education systems, that costs something. And if they want to spread that cost, that involves debt. And then under those circumstances, in general, it will not be a good idea for you to pay back all your debt.
Prima, perché lo Stato per uscire dalla crisi non emette titoli del tesoro senza interesse a corso legale, evitando così di indebitarsi? E la seconda è, qual è la giustificazione per conferire il potere a delle banche centrali indipendenti, a volte private, come nel caso della Banca d'Italia, della Federal Reserve, per regolare il mercato? Non c'è una sorta di conflitto di interessi tra l'interesse della popolazione e quello dei privati cittadini? La terza riguarda l'eticità dell'economia. E riprendo un momento quello che si era parlato nella conferenza precedente, con Sadun precedentemente notava che i settori più colpiti sono stati quello finanziario e immobiliare, essendo considerati più speculativi. Non sarebbe utile ipotizzare una sorta di moralità o etica che possa regolare maggiormente il sistema economico finanziario. Grazie.
Sono domande abbastanza borderline, diciamo. In particolare, io sinceramente la prima non l'ho capita molto bene, però siccome non sono premio Nobel per fortuna.
It's one of these things where everybody looks to the right and there's no one to the right.
If I understand the question, and you'll shake your head up and down if I did or if no, because then I'll stop. It was a question about why don't we issue debt with no interest or no. Okay, then I'm afraid I don't know either what your question was. No, he just shook his head no. I mean, you may have that question.
But yeah, the point is why can we make like treasury bills, legal tender, without the need to repay them. So it's not a debt because you don't need to repay them. It's what Lincoln did with the greenbacks. That was the point, my question.
Okay. As I hear it, you're saying, why do we have a distinction between what we call money or legal tender and full faith and credit issues of the corresponding government? I'm not sure I'm the one to opine on all the reasons, but that distinction is a matter of what is absolutely legal. You can demand that settlement for law. I cannot compel you now to accept a U.S. government bond as a settlement of an obligation, a financial obligation I have. If you're talking about simply issuing kind of money with an interest rate embedded in it with some maturity, but otherwise you're just simply saying that there's no distinction between money and debt, and why should we have that? And I'm not sure there's a good answer, a full answer to that, but I think we somehow think that certain governments perceive the seniorage as having value. But if there are no interest, maybe that is an issue. I don't know. Anyone wants to add on?
Can I add a little bit to that? First of all, right now, the interest rate on 90-day treasury bills in the U.S. is very close to zero. So there is, in effect, zero interest financing. Secondly, we do turn treasury bills into cash. When the government, the treasury, sells its debt, short-term debt, to the Federal Reserve, that's in fact what happens. The debt is simply money. Is the belief, true or false, when we talk about that, that the stock of cash, of legal tender, means of payment in the economic system, has effects on prices, on spending, and so on, that the stock of even short-term debt does not have. But in fact, it's clear that you could imagine a whole spectrum of risk-free debt, treasury debt. Instead of 90-day bills, imagine 20-day bills. There are 20-day bills. There are 90-day bills that were issued 70 days ago. And what we're concerned about is the amount of liquidity. The interest cost is negligible.
I'm not sure if this is exactly the same question, but you know, a kind of correlated type issue is many people around the world feel that there's so much debt in the world, and so much indebtedness. Maybe central banks everywhere should tolerate a higher inflation for a while. So a little bit of printing more money, allowing inflation to go out to 4, 5, 6%, And that's a lot of headaches for indebted households and corporations in many countries.
Domanda sulla Banca d'Italia, la Fed, privata, in realtà poi...